Welcome back to AJSpeller.com. In today's video, we're going to learn about the logic behind multiplying integers. Specifically, we're going to look at learning about what the resulting sign should be when multiplying two integers. But first, let's take a step back and let's fall back to something that I call the tic-tac-toe method. I shot a previous video talking about that. You begin by drawing the hashtag or tic-tac-toe symbol. And then along the diagonal, you're going to place plus signs, the positives, and in the remaining open spaces, you're going to place in negative signs. All right, the way this diagram works is that a positive times a negative will give you a negative. A negative times a negative results in a positive. Positive times a positive also results in a positive. Notice that any winning tic-tac-toe move results in telling you what the sign would be of the product when you've multiplied those integers. Another way that I've learned how to remember what the sign should be is looking at the attitudes of people. So we're saying if two people go to lunch, and let's say that a person has a positive attitude and goes to lunch with a person with a positive attitude, the result of the experience would be something positive. If, on the other hand, a positive person went to lunch with a negative person, with them not being in agreement, the result will be a negative experience. And lastly, if a person with a negative attitude went to lunch with another person with a negative attitude, they'd pretty much be in agreement in their negativity, which would result in a positive experience for both. So either way, using the attitudes method or using the tic-tac-toe method, again, both of those allow you to try to remember what the signs should be for those products. But I had a question in a previous video where the person asked about what's the actual logic behind multiplying positive and negative numbers, and that's what we're going to go ahead and tackle now in this video. But first, before getting to that, we need to learn about a concept called a zero pair. A zero pair is where you have a positive and then a negative together. When those two come together, that pair leaves you with a result of zero, and that's why it's called a zero pair. All right, let's take a look at an example that I've set up previously. All right, let's say we start off with a positive 3 and want to multiply that by a positive 2. What I've gone ahead and done is I've actually created the with the groupings. One moment, let me switch something over. Now let's paste it in. All right, I've created three groups of 2. But what I want you to remember is that with the zero pair, this is really symbolizing zero, because a zero, 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 a zero, and a zero. So my net result is a zero. All right, but now let's go back to this problem. This here says I want to have three groups of 2, and I'm looking for a positive 2. So in doing that, I need to get rid of the negatives. So that means these negatives will go away, these two negatives will go away, and these two negatives will go away. In that, you see I have nothing left but positives, so I just count them up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I see the result is a positive 6. Let's go ahead and remove these lines here. So 3 times 2 results in a positive 6. And again, if we go back to the tic-tac-toe board, a positive times a positive results in a positive. Let's take a look at a different example. Again, let's use the negative 3 times a positive 2. Right, this time, this means that I want to remove from my groups of 3 positive 2. So if I look at my first group, I want to remove a positive 2. So that would be these two positives. From the second group, remove positive 2. And from the third group, remove a positive 2. At this point, you see I have nothing but negatives, so I tally them up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you see my answer comes out to be a negative 6. Let's undo that. So we have a negative 6 here, and if I go back to the tic-tac-toe chart, a negative times a positive will result in a negative. All right, let's take a look at another example. Let's say we have a negative 2 times Oh, I'm sorry, let's go back. A negative 3 times a negative 2. This here is saying that I want to remove from my group of 3 negative 2. So if I remove negative 2 from the first group, and I remove negative 2 from the second group, and I remove negative 2 from the third group, you see I have nothing left but positives 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So a negative times a negative gives me a positive 6. And here, if we look at this example, negative times a negative gives a positive. Or if we went from bottom to top, a negative times a negative gives me a positive. And let's take a look at the last one that I want to do. And with that, we're going to have a a positive 3 times a negative 2. So here I'm saying I want to keep 3 negative 2s. So that means if I want to keep the negative 2s, I need to remove the positive. So I remove the positive 2, remove the positive 2, and remove the positive 2. Here I have nothing left but negatives. I add those up or count them, and you see I'm left with negative 6. And again, if I go here to my chart, a positive times a negative. So a positive times a negative will result in a negative. All right, I hope that this video was clear, or maybe helped you better understand what to do when, or what the logic is when multiplying integers. I want to thank you for viewing another video by ajspeller.com.